Welcome back to CN2 News. I'm David Metzel. Today we're joined by a pastor and an author, one and the same, Pastor C.T. Kirk. Welcome to CN2.
Thank you, sir.
And I understand you've recently become an author.
Yes, sir.
And if you want to tell us a little bit about what inspired you to write a book.
Well, this is my first book, and it's called Learn to Take Back Your Mind, Strategizing, Unifying, and Praying Your Way Up. And this book is actually a devotion prepared to help the reader see where they are in life and get to the next destination or the next point in their life. I always wanted to be an author. I grew up here in Rock Hill, loved the city. My life is pretty much as average life as a young man in the 80s. My mother was a single parent mother who really raised me. But at 6 years old, my life kind of took a detour. I was affected in a way that no child should ever have to go through. At 6 years old, I was molested by a group of neighborhood boys. I was going to visit some of my best friends, and they were not home, but his brother and some of his friends were there, and they thought it was funny to molest me.
Goodness, and then obviously that left a terrible scar on a six-year-old. No fault of your own, this terrible thing happened. And how did you react with that? How did you deal with that?
Well, because I was 6 years old, I didn't understand it, but I remember one of the boys saying, if you ever tell anybody that they're going to get you because it was your fault. And so I grew up my whole life thinking that that instance was my fault, and it caused me a lot of times to be bitter because I felt like the guys were not punished for what they did in life. It caused me to go through many relationship up and downs, really just a lot of insecurity, low self-esteem and depression, and really just to the point I tried to commit suicide twice just because I didn't feel like I was loved.
A lot of people are hiding these secrets. How is it that you were able to be able to finally talk about it and get help?
Well, when I started writing the book, I didn't write the book from a place of completeness. I wrote the book from a place of hurt. And the more I started reading what I wrote, I knew that it was not me writing, but it was inspired by God. And so the more I started reading over the pages, the more it started healing me to the point that I was able to confess what had happened in my life. And so in other words, my brokenness led me to really being able to write my healing.
What do you hope people that get to read your book take away from this?
I think a lot of people are hurting but not able to express their hurt. And even though they smile on the outside, a lot of people still are going through in the inward part of their self. And so I think that this book is really going to pull out those things that we've been hurt, those things that we have in our past, because I had to learn that our past is the greatest instrument to be able to promote our future. And a lot of times God will use what we've been through, our experiences, to really promote and help someone else come out of the same things we've been in. It's not only just for people that's hurt, but it's for any facet of life that you are in. I think it's a book that everyone needs to read to really be inspired that, hey, my life has a greater meaning than I ever thought about.
Well, I certainly hope it inspires people. And how old were you during these suicide attempts?
Oh, I went through them at 16. Then I had another just the bad thought in my mind in 20. And we get stuck in life a lot of times because we haven't dealt with those issues that have plagued us in our past. And so it was only when I learned that, listen, okay, you experienced that, but God made you stronger, was I able to share the story.
Could you take us through the journey between the roughest times of your life and when things started to change for you, or when you made changes about who you are now?
I had a lot of rough patches, and a lot of times I tried to be a clown to overcompensate for my rough passage. So I would try to make everybody laugh. I would try to be everybody's friend. Just battling with depression was a very low time for me. And so it was only when I had an altercation with another fellow over a female, end up getting arrested, going to jail, and meeting a pastor on the inside that really inspired me and say, you know what, you're not supposed to be here. There's greater for your life, and there's more that you need to do in life. When I got out of there, I met my wife. I graduated from York Tech with a business degree, but decided I wanted to be a teacher. Well, while waiting to teach, I got laid off from a job. It's really when I had time to really sit down and write the book. I took the job at the Haven. And from there, I was able to meet a lot of different people that were broken. A lot of people look at homeless people and they say, okay, it's because you want to be homeless. It's because you didn't take an opportunity. It's because you got a drug problem. You got a drinking problem. But they don't realize how many people are addicted to their past and addicted to the hurt and never recuperate from the hurt. And because of that, it leads them down these different roads. And so being in there gave me more motivation to keep writing because I was able to see real life ministry in action. It was the greatest sermon I was ever able to see was working right at the Haven where I was seen and was able to counsel men through their darkest places. And I think only when we learn who we are first can we really express ourselves the way we should. And I remember looking at myself saying, there's a little boy, a little six-year-old boy that never was able to heal. And so only when I allowed that young man to be forgiven, that six-year-old, and I told him, you know, I forgive you for what happened to you. It wasn't your fault. You're loved. You're wonderful. Was I able to really heal.
And how can people find your book if they want to read it?
They can go to our website. It's www.higherthinkingelements.com. Go there, order the book. Again, www.higherthinkingelements.com.
I certainly hope people get a chance to read it or even buy it as a gift to give to friends that they think might benefit from it. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much, sir.
Absolutely. And thank you for watching. We'll be back right after this.